Lions of the Eagle.
This one is brewing to be entertaining on my high definition set.
I can see the stubborn slave generation sinking crocodile gallons divinely are still going against the law overhead in spite of being warned, just like the defiance of the social distance in the global pandemic. Oh hell.
Thank you.
give me one listening ear. Record this Allow me introduce to you this
Project. My dear beloved protagonist, I welcomed your revolutionary invitation. I bet that I'm your first pick for the global elite terrestrial warriors that would become divine, above all of Jamaica's crocodile gals, especially above that croc whose crooked wig, that I, Sarah Lee, has bravely removed, in the Valley of Megiddo. What a spoonful of such prophecy to the
Synopsis. For Lions of the Christ. And Alpha Elite team of a number of warriors is on a quest every 3 months and 4 days to defend Earth 1 and Earth 2 through a compulsory tournament by the name of Championship, which complements Biblical Ephesians 6 verse 12. However, prior to this, ornament consists of only the Green Earth 2 contestants. So to draw its winner in the ultimate event, the very GVE Championship for the ultimate prize, it's Filthy
in the Game.
Lions of the Christ, spiritual battles, embark.
Wow, she is so championship, as she has the American spirit. I must gear up my energy for this legend.
Shemale is truly the worthy contestant gamer here. I wonder how Reds of TNT will overcome her in this mini tournament in the Good versus Evil cage, since Shemale has already won a number of MC game titles, and if she should win this present mini tournament, despite it had not been drafted by the adversary Emperor Darkheart, so to enter in the grand event, the Good vs. Evil tournament, it may would have been her sixth. However, God is on her side, for the blazingly hot God Gamer, the greatest fire in the Empire, the very hellish Divine Emperor, Aaron L. Bonner, is officially now the successor, because he's the only omnipresence in reality, which can literally unite all in one, as he is the fullness of Biblical Ephesians 1:23, that truly fills all in all. But Reds, of TNT, is making her debut.
The latest installment. No wonder the many schoolers flocked here.
Imagine such succulent lips massaging me below, in light coconut apparel. Wow, I must defeat her in this casual mini tournament, and give her the opportunity in serving me forever, or just take the highway.
Did you hear that?
Hell yeah, the game tournament has officially begun.
Now,
Female daringly sprung up in the air with lion legs. Wow, I remember my young brother, the ninja Wally, the moment I saw Shemale's talented leap and to the dragon.
Eagle.
But look, she's breaking.
Wow, she nailed their ego here by legs. Wow, I remember my young brother, Ninja Wally, the moment I saw Chanel's talent. Into the dragon.
And action.
This is
2-in-1.
Where'd you get it from?
Over there.
Over there? For God's sake, please stop it. There's no more time. You've got to... Please, stop it. Stop it now. Turn it off. Turn it off. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
Body count.
Do you? People actually care about that shit?
Men in general.
If a man is asking me a body count, he can get
Wow.
Who gives a Oh my god, that's so stupid. People actually ask that shit?
Yes.
You okay, well then you're talking to the wrong man. If a man is ever asking about your body count, you're talking to the wrong man and he can get like that's stupid. Get
You would only be defensive about it if your number's kinda high. Like, I think body count is something that both men and women should be a little concerned about when it comes to dating somebody. And not because it makes you particularly disgusting as a woman or as a man. It speaks to how you value yourself, what you value when it comes to relationships, whether or not sex is a major thing for you or something that you feel like can be quite frivolous and can be thrown around.
A shadow scorcher, delusion to love, a sorry leaf, heavenly discussion about how the naming tournament has been going thus far. Then suddenly...
Wow. She-male daringly sprung up in the air with lion legs.
one of Darren's, the omnipresence's warrioress by the name of Tongli, who is at his hand. One started moderating the simple rules of the many tournaments to the man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the hybrid warriors of the team, Lions of the Eagle, which has been the now evolved World Heroic Team, from the classic team, by the name of Lions of the Christ, are having a discussion, wondering, how low would the surplus bloodletting end, through the game, for the mini tournament is yet to produce the winner for its initial match. Shemale versus Reds. Remember that through this game that you're playing, we keep it in the game, and finished such, through the game, in honor of the biblical holy creed, in Ephesians 6:12, which stated, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, and against powers. And that's as far, as we, the truth bearers, outside of Psalm 2, Fa's derision, of the Lord, spelt with only one capital consonant letter, the letter, L, will get. The rules are simple, let your opponent surrender to your will, by an invitation, or just give your opponent the universal KO. G, aim on. Gentlemen, the hybrid warriors of the team, Lions of the Eagle, which has been the now evolved World Heroic Team, from the classic team, by the name of Lions of the Christ, are having a discussion, wondering, how low would the surplus bloodletting end, through the game, for the mini tournament is yet to produce the winner for its initial match. Shemale versus Reds. Remember that through this game that you're playing, ladies, you keep it in the game, and finish such, through the game, in honor of the biblical holy creed, in Ephesians 6:12, which stated, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and against powers. Having a discussion, and that's as far as we, the truth bearer, through the game, for the mini tournament is yet to produce the winner for. And against powers. And that's as far as we, the truth bearers, outside of Psalm 2, God's derision of the Lord, spelt with only one capital consonant letter, the letter L, will get. The rules are simple, let your opponent surrender to your will, by an invitation, or just give your opponent the universal K. G, aim on.
No time is left. one more time. Just using my raw talent this time. Now, my wonderful, compulsory, beloved souls. And you know that my voice is compulsory because your soul is part of it. And I mean actually part of the great component. I am the supreme soul. Therefore, you will always hear me. Remember that the Bible said Jesus Christ came and reconciled the world through his death. In other words,
Lions of the
Eagle. Or in short, of the glory of God.
Wow, I remember my young brother, Ninja Wally, the moment I saw Shemale's talent. Into the dragon.
Paradise. This that to save the garden, which can be seen in the account in the book of Genesis. Then in process of time, from the union bond, the Lord, spelled with one capital consonant, letter L, came and paid for what had been done from the initial stage. Through his crucifixion, he reconciled all, and I mean all of you over 7 billion audience back to one. The same that you're hearing is the one. I, Biblical Ephesians 1:23, in the very humanity of Aaron L. Bonner. Therefore, as I'm unraveling the oracle through my audio book, which is actually a developing project, a super project, actually, would like to give a summary of what is taking place thus far. So while Reds is in a heated battle against her opponent Shemale, all in the game, remember, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers. And as far as I will get in the game, it's against technology. That's the reason why you see flashy Vizio playing the game. However, this does not make the judgment of God exempted against the rebellious of the earth. Now, Bobby, you were saying, so the battle was taking place in the good versus evil cave. Then suddenly, an enormous vision had been transpired in their midst, which had taken away the attention of the interior gathering. This or that is to say, the hellish divine congregation. But the contestants, namely Reds and one more, which is Empress Shimon. Of the occurrence. Therefore, these elected ones were perpetuating the mini tournament as the raging battle within the phase, the very first phase of the game, continues. Having said that, when all this vision, which is futuristic, had been subsided, then the audience, which was in the good versus evil cave, continue from where they were distracted by. It's as if time stopped just for the revelation about Armageddon. As I said, the rebellious must not feel so happy.
Against these.
I can see the stubborn slave generation sinking crocodile down divinely, are still going against the law overhead, in spite of being warned, just like the defiance of the social distance global pandemic. Oh hell. crocodile gallop divinely are still going against the law overhead, in spite of being warned, just like the defiance of the social system to the global man.
My audiobook, which is actually a developing project, a super project, actually, would like to give a summary of what is taking place thus far. So while Reds is in a heated battle against her opponent Shemale, all in the game. Remember, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities. Against powers. That's as far as I will get. In the game, it's against technology. The reason why it's ego is playing the game. However,
she's breaking her sweat.
Habakkuk 2:14.
decree and declare that Jesus, the one capital consonant letter L, has been dethroned because I am here officially. Now for my testament. The inscription is: the only true king of the universe. God of gods, the Lord of hell, Moloch, chapter 1, verse 1. You're Jesus with the one capital consonant letter L has put you in derision, not just the heathen, but his church. I want you to understand that there's nothing in secret which is hidden that will not be revealed. Didn't he say that when I come, I shall lead the world to all truth? Now let me show you in chapter 1 of my testament, reading from verse 1, how your Lord hide things about himself. However, such thing was recorded because my glory that covers the whole universe and beyond had inspired such, so that you can see it written. Now I want you to understand that your Jesus had secretly invested in my kingdom. If you do not believe when I say my kingdom, I'm talking about the kingdom of hell in absoluteness, hell above, hell on the earth, as well as hell beneath the earth, the absoluteness of power. Why did he invest it in my kingdom? He gave one of my disciples Judas Iscariot. The bag of money. This was done, symbolizing his true allegiance. But he polishes off such with the gospel that you all preaching and being sacrificed for. Such derision. Let me explain that he was caught hiding away. First, you'll see in John chapter 7, verse 10, it is written, in the subtopic, Christ secretly goes to the feast. Now verse 10 says, but when his brethren were gone up, then went he also up unto the feast, not openly, but as it were in secret. Ha, 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 ha. I told you why he didn't let his disciples see him. If he's the way, the truth, and the life, didn't he speak that he's the light of the world? Then why hiding such thing? His life should have been the message of God, but he failed in this. However, I think he's clever because he knew the wicked would come. So he makes certain he trapped them with the gospel, so that they be beheaded. Moloch chapter 1, verse 1. Now back to the tournament. As you have known, this is an analogy. Such is the reason why the book is Lions of the Eagle analogy.
Operating.
watching, seemingly elected ones, going at it.
Wow, look how easily Shemale blocked Red's spinning kick.
It says,
Then said one of his disciples, Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, which should betray him. Why was not this ointment sold for 300 pence and given to the poor? Now I read the final verse when reading from John chapter 12, verse 4 to 6. Verse 6 says, this he said, not that he cared for the poor, but because he was a thief and had the bag and fear what was put therein. Now, my over 7 billion audience, I do not need disciples like your Lord. Those who are in Christendom that embrace him. One of his disciples was my disciple, who betrayed him. He invested in me. Now you know why in the kingdom of hell we are the richest in the whole earth. There was a paradigm shift when he gave the treasury over to my servant who betrayed him. However, I think he was being clever, for he knew the wicked would come and be beheaded through the gospel that he used to polish off this which you have just read. It would have appeared that he is against Judas. However, the scripture said one of his disciples. So, really, Jesus was an undercover agent of the kingdom of hell. He was setting things in motion for Moloch. Don't you know that a faithful prophet by the name Samuel, after he had finished his course, this is to say, or that is to say, his mission on earth, he was embracing eternal life. Then after he closed his eye, he was awakened in the unimaginable hell ruled by Moloch. His soul was kept beneath the earth, and the witch caused such to be revealed. So where was his God after he served them faithfully for so long until death? His God was not there. The derision was set in motion. He was in for a rude awakening. You may see this passage.
For a rude awakening.
In The Book of Samuel. You may search for yourself diligently about the Witch of Endor. I don't spoon-feed the crocs. The crocs must feed themselves. Now back to the tournament. The mini tournament. At least.
Objective list of celebrities like Beyonce, Alicia Keys, Rihanna, Mariah Carey, to certain spiritual revolutionary preachers of My Inward Messiah, of Biblical John 14, 17, BNU, Dispensation, etc. Fills me up frequently, internally, orally. Wow.
Why?
Explicit content.
Well, see your faith in my creativity. For you know,
I spoon feed you. It's the best. Now, full jaw, the rest is legend, divine, show.
Almost finished. After all, I guess without a doubt, that I need a popcorn diet despite of the delicious buttery milky taste, as my beloved royal husband, Biblical Ephesians 1:23, Kirby Cock, which has me up the whole night.
Episode 5. After all of what had taken place, thus far. A tournament by the name of Mini Tournament Scorpion, which is Ashala, DJ, which is Telshore Chulaki, and Azari Lee are watching the mini tournament, plus having a discussion about who they think would qualify in this game for the good versus evil. Now, on behalf of Biblical Ephesians 1:23, I hereby
Hot tornado.
Make my public speech to you that sit on the throne, who I know will eventually be defeated by the successor, the same Biblical Ephesians 1:23, for he is indeed deserving. I want you to understand, I am participating in this spiritual quest. You have seen the power that I have. I want you to replace me with Phoenix of Japan on behalf of Aaron L. Bonner, the true leader that will take over where you are. Therefore, I am going to finish my opponent using my most powerful power. Yeah.
What awesomeness is he?
Hear me up. Tell Zor Jolaki. I know that you make very good decisions, but I must let you know, according to our protocol, ever since, those who will enter into this classic elite team, which is Lions of the Christ, must prove themselves. Now, concerning Phoenix, this Japanese girl, we do not know her potential. Neither does she claim any victory. Only that she was granted great favor to go in the final of the mini tournament, because as you can see, Hot Tornado is far powerful than his opponent, so for sure he will go in the final and face Shemale, the fifth time champion of this mini tournament. Nevertheless, this will not make her a true warrior by going in the final, since she replaced her Tornado. I want you, since you are the captain, and not only that, you are the decision maker. Most importantly, must let she prove herself. Not at the final, but let she go in the House of Slaughter to battle slave what will beat her. Azari needs Ninja Brother. Hawali. In this now, we will know that for sure she is worthy, not just to battle Shemale in the final, but to be part of our classic team. Remember that Samai has been punished. She's no longer part of this team. However, she's part of this revolutionary team which you have joined, that Aaron had formed. So, may you courteously grant me my request. I am always your right hand, so you can listen.
I, Phoenix, knows that Telshor is not like me. What a jerk.
My dear beloved protagonist, I welcomed your revolutionary invitation. I bet that I'm your first pick for the global elite terrestrial warriors that would become divine, above all of Jamaica's crocodile gals, especially above that croc whose crooked wig, that I, Sarah Lee, has bravely removed, in the Valley of Megiddo. What a spoonful of such prophecy for the be
child for her. And if she defeated, if she should defeat you, then she would be inducted.
Phoenix
higher, higher,
higher,
higher, higher, higher, higher.
As a replacement for Samurai, as we are known in the first Good vs. Evil Championship Tournament. So, prepare yourself, Master of the House of Slaughter, for your next opponent.
Thank you.
Thank you. Suggest to your seemingly bewildered opponent, let's serve your or Did you hear that?
Hell yeah, the game.
Oh no more, the electric. Oh, I can see it. I'll do anything, and I met any damn thing you want. You want just. The D-Electric. Oh, she. What? 3 days or 4 days? Just call it. And if you should make me your slave, just please make it snappy. Tie me to your coconut tree.
My dear beloved protagonist, I welcomed your revolutionary invitation. I bet that I'm your first pick for the global industrial warriors that would become divine, above all of Jamaica's crocodile gals, especially above that croc-tooth crooked wig that I, Sarah Lee, has bravely removed in the Valley of Megiddo. What a spoonful of such prophecy for the
game.
My, over 7 billion listeners who can't stop listening, for you know your soul is a fragment of the supreme soul, which is Aaron L. Bonner. The omnipresence in the volume of biblical Ephesians 1:23 and biblical Habakkuk 2:14. Tournament, the initial stage has just finished. Now I, King of the whole universe and all realms, visible and invisible, would like to continue now the testament of Moloch, the god of fire. Moloch chapter 1 verse number 10. Now, recording the initial covenant of the Lord, all caps. This is to say, or that is to say, capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D. Has brought forth his first ever high priest, who was King of Salem, Melchizedek, who was also the leader in his time for the covenant, as he led Abraham, whom by the Holy Scriptures refer to as Father of the Faith. Now, in 2 Kings chapter 5, verse number 18, there is something quite astonishing. For a warrior by the name of Naaman, who was a Syrian by nature, he was not of the stock of the chosen people. According to those in Christendom, Israel. However, despite being not of such a chosen gathering, this is to say, or that is to say, the people of Israel, the all capital letter, which is Lord, used him. So in delivering this nation, which by history is classified as pagan because they didn't worship the God of Israel, I read now verse 1 of 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 1 says, Now Naaman, captain of the host of the king of Syria, was a great man with his master and honorable, because by him the Lord had given deliverance unto Syria. He was also a mighty man in valor, but he was a leper. End of verse 1. So, in verse 1, this man whom many would consider not chosen because he's of the pagan world, was in the sight of the all capital letter truly worthy, because he was used by the same that you are hearing right now, who used this man by the name Naaman. However, let me skip to verse number 18. Because he was a leper, and he met the prophet by the name Elisha, who was serving the God of Israel. Now hear what he said unto him. He was speaking unto Elisha. He said, in this thing the Lord pardon thy servant, that when my master goeth into the house of Rimmon to worship there, and he leaneth on my hand, and I bow myself in the house of Rimmon. When I bow down myself in the house of Rimmon, the Lord pardon thy servant in this thing. End of verse number 18. So this man of valor, he was asking pardon because he was going to worship the first God that he knew, who was also the same power that delivered his people. The all capital letter. So, even though he was not worshiping the God of Israel, yet the all capital letter was there using him. Now, as I am reading this passage in Malachi chapter 1 verse 10, I want you understand that is the same all capital letter. So he was asking for pardon. Now, what you need to remember is that in the army of Israel, the dispensation was not according to the army of Syria, for they are fairies. However, he asks for pardon. And let me tell you, indeed he was pardoned, because he has been worshiping such God while his country was in need, and the Lord delivered his country by his hand, who was considered a pagan. Now let's go in the time of the eternal kingdom, as prophesied in the prophet Micah. Now I read Micah chapter 4, verse number 4. And 5. Now, Here is what's written. But they shall sit every man under his vine and under his fig tree, and none shall make them afraid. For the mouth of the Lord, which is all capital letter, of hosts hath spoken it. Now verse 5. The last verse, concluding Moloch chapter 1 verse 10. For all people will walk everyone in the name of his God, which is common letters, common G, common O, common D. Then you have the punctuation. And we will walk in the name of the Lord, which is all capital letter. Capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D. Our God, which is capital G, followed by the common letter. O.D. forever and ever. End of the stanza of verse 5. So, this is the mind of Moloch, giving the people a choice. Now, if I read about your Jesus, he doesn't give this option, my friends. Let me let you see what he says right here. When he gave the new covenant, which is the second covenant, after the covenant which Abraham knew, which was the first, even though he heard the gospel, for the Bible said that he heard the gospel. Galatians, which is an epistle of my servant Paul, who was the servant of your Lord Jesus Christ. He wrote according to what I revealed him. He says right here in Galatians 3, verse number 8. And the scripture foreseen that God would justify the heathen through faith, preach before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, in thee shall all nations be blessed. End of the stanza of verse number 8. So, as I continue reading Moloch chapter 1, verse 10, I want you to understand that the scripture says, God, the capital G, followed by the common letter, O-D, the same God of Micah chapter 4, verse number 4. the Lord, all capital letters. So he is God, capital G, followed by common letter. O, and one more letter, D, which is also common. So this God revealed to him, Jesus, on the other hand, started the new covenant, which is the second. Now I want you to understand that Jesus forbid you worshiping other gods. For he said unto Satan, who many would consider as Moloch, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him alone shalt thou serve. Let me read the passage. Because 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 21 says, prove all things and hold fast to that which is good. So let's hold fast to the word, this word. Now I read, now, Matthew chapter 4, verse 10, it is quite interesting that the all capital letter, who is capital S for the word spirit, brought your Jesus to be tempted by Satan, who many would refer to as Moloch. So in this passage, look what happened. Let me read from verse 1. It says, verse 1 of St. Matthew chapter 4. Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. In some translation, you'll see capital S. However, the definite article, the, let you know that this spirit is not an ordinary spirit. So then was Jesus led up of the spirit. So if you see the immediately before the word spirit, no matter how it is written, this D is the supreme, that's the word, meaning of the ultimate, also means so much. So the spirit, in other translation, you'll see capital S, to be tempted of the devil. So let me convey this message for my over 7 billion listeners. Jesus, after he was tempted, he rebuked Satan. And this is what he said in verse 10. The scripture says, then said Jesus unto him, now this is what Jesus, who is part of the hellish divine union bond, says, said, Get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Ha, 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 I told you, your Jesus, he doesn't agree with what the all capital letter had disclosed in Micah. For the word is the word of God. The old covenant also had the gospel that these in Christendom is following. However, they are following the gospel according to the second covenant. Your Jesus way of things. Let me go further in the message. We are still reading this long verse of Malachi chapter 1 verse 10. This enormous verse. For my royal listeners, Abraham was a holy man of God. He had a wife who was alive, and he had taken concubines. Concubines are those who are not in the marital level. They are not part of the matrimony. So Abraham, according to the second covenant, had committed adultery because he had his wife alive. His wife's name was Keturah. So Abraham had concubines. Now I, King of the universe and beyond, the only omnipresence, as I said, I am not your Jesus, who is part of the same union bond that I am in. He had 12 disciples. One of them was my disciple, Judas, and he betrayed him. He invested in my disciple. He gave him the treasurer, the treasury office. Now this is the reason why the kingdom of Satan is very affluent throughout the world, because Jesus gave what he was blessed with after he performed these wondrous miracles. Many gave offering, tithes, and he took it and gave in the hand of my servant to take care of the money. He didn't give to Peter, whom he said, upon this rock I built my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. He didn't give Peter those that gave him their life's living. Even the poor widow, she gave all, the Bible said, of what she had her whole life, gave Jesus, and Jesus glorified her, saying, many came and put in the bag what they want, even though it was much. However, this poor widow gave all that she had. Now let me tell you, you cannot stop hearing me because I am the supreme soul. Your soul is just a fragment, so you can't escape the power of the universe, myself, the supreme soul, Moloch, in the person of biblical Ephesians 1:23, the very fullness that fills all in all. So Jesus took this poor widow's faith, all that she earned, and gave it to one whom he called a devil. Jesus, after he chose 12, he said, I chose 12 of you, and one of you is a devil. So Judas was the devil, according to the passage. Judas had my spirit. He held the money because God's son, Jesus, gave him. So all those who believe in the Lord Jesus, who gave their offering sacrificially, Jesus handed over to my servant such powerful investment. He used his talent, he used his gifts, and gave everything to my servant. Can you imagine the transfer of power and wealth to the kingdom of hell? So he was my agent. In fact, Jesus came around me several times. He doesn't even make the church know these things. He's also my emissary. He's not the Jesus that you once knew. It says in the Bible that the vine shall bend towards the eagle. If you read the passage, you will know what I'm talking about. So the Bible gave glory this power by the name eagle. So this eagle is the power of God in the analogy. So your vine, Jesus is the vine according to the parable. Bend over, in other words, he bow before the eagle. So you know why he surrendered the church unto Satan. Just as, he surrendered the money which he used, blessing those who gave him because they believe in God. He surrendered the money unto my servant Judas Iscariot. Now he surrendered the whole church over to Satan. I am letting you know, Jesus is an undercover agent. Now let me show you in the first covenant, the initial covenant, because I do not want to offend those who doesn't like to hear the word first. So let me polish such cushioning your soul, who are not of this primary covenant, by saying the initial covenant. You know the initial covenant. What was the initial covenant? Abraham heard the initial covenant. So let me tell you, Abraham, let me read Genesis chapter 25 verse 1. It says, then again, Abram took a wife, and her name was Keturah. End of the first stanza. Oh, my apology. End of the initial stanza of Genesis chapter 25. As I said, I do not want to hurt the ears of those who are part of Christendom. You know yourselves. Let me not hurt them. So Abram took again one more wife. Now let me read verse 2. This is your favorite part, those in Christendom. Verse 2 says, and she bare him Zimran and Jokshan and Medan and Midian and Ishbak and Shua. End of the stanza of verse 2. Now, before I read the concluded part to show you that while his wife was alive, he had, as some would say, women on the side. I want you to understand this is violating the covenant which your Jesus established. Listen, now verse number 6 says, but unto the sons of the concubines, which Abram had, Abram gave gifts and send them away from Isaac his son, while he yet lived, eastward unto the east country. Now you have seen for yourself, you may open your own Bible. Abraham, according to your Jesus, in this passage, according to your pastors, is in error, committing sin, because if a pastor in Christendom has a wife and has a woman on the side, in this situation Abraham had, woman, plural. So in other words, such thing of no was no offense for his faith. Some pastor would be hiding in Christendom, having a woman on the side, because in Christendom, your Jesus had declared such is an adultery. And in other words, is an adulterous act. He would have been called an adulterer because he's a male. And those females who had sexual intercourse with him would have been called fornicators. This is actually the Old Testament explaining. So Abraham took concubines, in other words, whom he commit fornication with. So who is a concubine? An unmarried woman. Remember, he had a new wife by the name Keturah. So how Abraham is set as an example, being called father of faith in such adulterous act, why he was not punished? Because the all capital letter is the supreme power. His covenant was not Jesus's covenant. Jesus is responsible for the derision. I told you that you are in for a rude awakening, just like Samuel the prophet. He served him for so long, then after he closed his eyes, he was in the unimaginable, a place that he could not dare imagine. He was in the rude awakening. So my people, you have heard my testament coming from Melchizedek. And I know in the afterlife you will see your Jesus bowing. So the scripture fulfilled in the very passage of Ezekiel. Let me read, concluding Malachi chapter 1, verse 10. Ezekiel was a righteous prophet of God. He had locks. If you don't know, you should read the whole passage of Ezekiel. He received a powerful revelation. Now, for my listeners, as I said, I don't need ambassadors. Jesus had his disciples so that the whole people can hear him going throughout the world. I am in all. I don't need even the archangel that he needed so much. When I am here, in biblical Ephesians 1:23, the very fullness, I don't need the 12 disciples. All I need is my glory, which is sufficient. I let what he wanted to accomplish in his whole lifetime and after, which still could not he accomplish with all his disciples. I accomplished such thing in just a moment, because I am in all. Now Ezekiel 17 verse 7 says, there was also another great eagle with great wings and many feathers, and behold, this Vine did bend her roots toward him. Let me pause at verse 7. At this stanza, after the objective pronoun him. So, the vine was Jesus. He revealed to you in the new covenant that he is the vine and you're the branches. So Jesus bowed before this great eagle, Moloch. I'm explaining the oracle. So you know, your Jesus bow, he gave everything that he miraculously achieved over to the hand of the emissary of the devil, Satan. Yes, so he handed over the church as well. Listen, let me read once more and conclude at this moment for the slow learners. Ezekiel 17 verse 7. There was also another great eagle with great wings and many feathers, and behold, this vine did bend her roots toward him and shut forth her branches toward him, that he might water it by the furrows of her plantation. End of the stanza of verse 7. So he's handing over the whole church. Jesus said that he is the vine and you are the branches. So you know why this thing is going around the world for the church to be handed over unto Satan, as he handed over the bag of money which had the poor widows all of her life saving over to who you consider as the adversary. He gave such great wealth of those who believe in him to my servant. So he gave over all of you who trusted him, your fate over to the devil. So listeners, I have went in deep revelation, showing you scripture by scripture about Jesus, and that he was the very vine, the V-I-N-E. Yes, he said he's the vine and you're the branches. And I want you understand that your vine bow before the great eagle. Now I conclude John 15, verse number 1. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. So I end at this passage. Who is his Father? The husbandman, Moloch. So you see why he has to bow before him. He said that he's the true vine. Now hear what he says right here. In confirming about him being the vine and you, the church, the branches, which he handed over. Listen, in verse 5 of John 15, it says, I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me ye can do nothing. Yes, beloved listeners, you have heard Moloch giving you the scripture in concrete evidence. None of your pastors can compete with this vital truth. For I gave the scripture in its raw unfolding. So you see, Jesus is the vine. He said that in verse 5, I am the vine. You see the same common letters, V-I-N-E. You look in Ezekiel chapter 17, verse 7, you see the same common letters, V-I-N-E. It's your Jesus, the same spelling, all common letters. Now you see the word branches, the same spelling, all common letters, that he gave forth over to this one great eagle. The church he gave over to Moloch. So prepare yourself, because the time is at hand. End of Moloch chapter 1, verse number 10.
In other words, lies of the falling short of the glory of God.
Wow, I remember my young brother, Ninja Wally, the moment I saw him nail his
counter
into the dragon.
Paradise.
Jeez.